हेलो फ्रेंड्स, आई एम विजय सोलंकी एंड यू आर वाचिंग समथिंग ऑफ एवरीथिंग। इन दिस वीडियो वी विल गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट इफेक्टिव लेंथ फैक्टर्स ELY एंड ELZ इन स्टेट प्रो। व्हाई वी नीड टू गिव इफेक्टिव लेंथ फैक्टर्स? टू कैप्चर द अनरेस्ट कॉलम लेंथ इफेक्ट सो एज टू नो वेदर द कॉलम इज स्लेंडर और नॉट। We need to give effective length factors. As you can see, this column, this one, is braced in this direction in all the sections, but it is not braced in this direction. If you can see this, let us just take this column alone. Okay, now let's see the local axis of it. As you can see, the column is braced in y direction but not in z direction. So in order to get the complete picture of the column's unbrushedness, we have to give the effective length factor for this much height so that you can capture the actual column's effect. Mind well, we have to give the KL factor differently as per Annex E of IS 456-2000, which talks about the sway effect of the frame. Here we are only giving the length factor to make the state understand that the complete height of the column will be this much. The effect of unbrushed column can be evaluated by this much. ELY and ELZ parameters are to be used to calculate the effective lengths of columns to find whether it is a short column or a long column. State calculates LEX and LEY. Which are LEX and LEY? This one. LEX by D and LEY by B. For knowing that LEX, we have to give ELZ, and to get the actual LEY, you have to provide ELY. Okay? State takes YD as the D of in this. That means if your YD is the smaller direction, you have to provide ELZ. If the column is unbrushed in that direction, let us know how to provide the effective length factors. Let's first get the effective lengths of these columns. Not effective lengths. Okay, the columns are of 3.2 meter height and the total height of the column is 6.4. That means the effective length will be 6.4 by 3.2. That will be equal to 2.0. And the unbrushedness of the column can be taken as per Annex E of the code, that is this one. We have to provide the unbrushedness factor from this one along with this factor 2. Okay, let's just provide the factor 2. In which direction we have to provide the factor? That is most important in this case. As your column is braced in y direction and not in z direction, you have to provide effective length factor about y direction. Okay, let's just go to zen command parameters and let us see what ELY shows. It shows that member length factor about local y axis. About local y axis. Okay, that means we have to provide ELY in this case. Okay, select ELY and provide 2.0 in this case. Add after current, add it, and let us provide it to the members. This member and this member will be provided ELY. Okay, let us see whether any other column is unbrushed or not. As you can see, there is no other column unbrushed. Okay, it is okay. Let's run the analysis and see the output file, how the column is being calculated in this case. As the analysis has been done, let's go to the output file, and before it we have to see which column number is this, 27 and 28. Okay, let us see the result of column number 27 and 8. This is column number 28. It will be showing that breast long column. Why it is being long column? Because we have provided the length factor to it. To get the actual idea of it, we have to provide track 2. Let us see. By changing the track to track 2, by default the track will be 1. By default the EL factor for the members, that means columns, will be ELZ and ELY will be 1 by default. In case you have modeled the column such that it is being braced or it is being unbraced, you have to provide effective length factors. Let us see the result of column number 28. This column is this. Yes, this is column number 28. If you can see about Z, the length is, sorry, this is the moments. You have to see the lengths being calculated in this case, right? Initial moments about Y. The slenderness ratio is 17 and it is being long column in the Y direction. If you calculate it manually, let us see if it is calculating it actually right or not. As you can see, the column size is X, so that we can see the column size. The column size is 230 by 380. Okay, so we have to get this value and it will come out to be 6400 by 380. It comes out to be 16.84. Okay, it is coming 17.01 in this case. Why? Because the cross section size is 375. Let us see it, whether it is being okay or not. Let's say 6400 by 375. It is 17.07. It means it has captured the actual effect of the length of an unbraced column and provided the long column moments, extra moments that needs to be calculated. Okay, that's perfect. Always try to provide effective length factors whenever required. Otherwise, the column design results will be erroneous. Thank you for watching this.
Thank you for watching this video and please subscribe our channel.